decision promotes distinction by the course of action. When we dwell long enough on a particular thought, glands or chemicals are produced from a particular part of our brain that begin to instigate a particular feeling in line with that thought. So you can think of your best meal in your mind and begin to eat it in your mind. And while you are thinking in your mind, it will be as though you are actually eating that food. You can think of yourself in your private jet, and if you can hold that talk long and strong enough, you will actually begin to feel like somebody in a private jet. Now listen to me, ladies and gentlemen, this feeling is what you need to achieve to send the attraction of what you desire into the world. If you can do that long enough and consistently enough, before you know it, you will be embracing the very thing that you're thinking about. Your emotions are piloted by the focus of your thoughts, by the subject of your thoughts. So if you're thinking debt, you are going to be in debt. If you're thinking management, you are going to be in management. If you're thinking struggling, you are going to struggle. If you're thinking wealth, be sure you're going to be wealthy. Whatever you're thinking about, the subject of what you're thinking about, no matter how you are thinking about it, either to the left or to the right, positive or negative, as long as you are thinking of a subject, that subject you will attract into your life. The subject of what you are thinking about runs your feelings, and that is what commands the power of attraction. Never forget this equation: meditation, imagination, navigation, and decision. That's how you mind your business. Meditation, imagination, navigation, decision. That's how you mind your business. That's how the mind creates a pattern traffic in and out of your life. That is why you notice that certain people go through the same things their parents went through, and their parents went through the same things their own grandparents went through, because a particular mindset, and because it's a mindset running through the whole family, it's keeps reproducing itself, the same results in their lives, no matter who they are. Nothing is more real than what you think. Nothing is more real than what you are thinking right now. Our situation is, we are usually drawn to the activities than productivity. We must learn to identify our most important people, our most important work, our most important idea, our most important dream, and spend 80% of our time thinking about them. Because the more you dwell on a particular thought, the more your feelings are generated in line with that thought. And if your feelings are generated in that line, then very soon your decisions will align and resources will be coming to you in that same pattern. Listen to me, your thoughts, your mind has the power to make or mar your life. So what are you thinking? Mind your business. My name is Edmund King, and my mission is to inspire you to be all you were born to be.